All right, let's talk about generating leads from Facebook. So this comes about as a response to a question. It says, Roy, I'm in real estate marketing and would like to know more things related to marketing and lead generation via Facebook. Can you give me some overarching principles or strategy? Thanks, Bradley. So actually, there's four big categories that you need to look at when it comes to this. And I'm going to talk specifically about real estate marketing and generating leads for real estate. But if you are in any other industry and you're looking to generate leads or customers via Facebook, most of the principles and strategies are still going to apply to you. So the four big categories, the four big things that you need to focus on are targeting, offer, campaign structure, and message. So as a copywriter, you might think I'd just say, oh, well, here's how you write a Facebook ad. But if you don't have these other three things right first, you're gonna struggle. Whereas when you get these other three things right and you do get the right message, then it becomes very easy to move people off of Facebook into your funnel, into your business as customers. So targeting, first and foremost, you have to advertise to somebody. And so who is your audience? Now, in real estate, of course, geography is going to play a big role. Location, 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 right? That feels a little trite to talk about. Think about who specifically, and not even necessarily an entire city or an entire DMA code, but you know, what zip codes do I want to focus on? What area of town? What radius around my office or around a specific point in my city? Like geographically, how do I want to target people? And then demographics, that is things like age, sex, income, things like that. That, of course, Facebook targeting is going to let you target some of these things, and is not going to let you target other things. But the more that you can think about these things ahead of time, if you think, well, okay, well, my ideal clients are of a certain net worth. And so what can I do to identify people who are of that net worth in this geographic area, etc.? And then interests. Facebook does let you do a lot of interest targeting, and you have to play around and figure out what they do let you target and what they don't. Things like job titles and things are easier to target because that tends to be more public data. Some other things are less easy to target, but if you start to, you should start to narrow down kind of who you want to focus on. But with Facebook, the algorithm works such wonders that if you are able to if you are able to start to narrow down, it's better to leave a little bit bigger audience and let the algorithm go to work. And this wasn't always true. It's better to leave a little bit bigger audience and let the algorithm go to work for optimizing things like conversions on a page or click-throughs to a page to then take the initial data that you give it and find more people like that in a bigger audience that you give it. So even if perhaps in your city, depending on the size of your city, and depending on the real estate market that you're going after, you could decide that you just want to target like half of your city or a big chunk of your city, and then tell Facebook, I want more people like the people who click through to my ads. And that will start to give you pretty good targeting once the algorithm starts to pick up some data from your advertising. But first off, think about who. Like, that's what targeting is about. It's about who I'm speaking to. Now, the next thing after targeting is offer. And I actually just released a video called Easy Offers Get Response. I'll make sure to include a link with this video as well. But basically, when I'm thinking about offers, when I'm talking about offers, I'm talking about the first step offer, not the final offer. Not like, oh, let me sell your house for you. But what is the first thing that somebody would be interested in looking at if they are starting to be in the market? So, for example, something as simple as buying and selling houses in Lincoln, Nebraska, or a home price buyer's guide in Lincoln, Nebraska based on zip code, or what are the best neighborhoods to move into in Lincoln, Nebraska, or whatever. Like, what is a very early bit of information that people might gather if they are at all in your market? And how can you package that in a way that makes it really easy for the prospect to respond? And then that offer should be designed to lead them down the path to purchase. So the various offers that I was talking about there, it could be, many of them are either indicative of or would be particularly attractive to someone who is either interested in buying a home or selling a home. And so I'm leading them down the path to purchase. And I need to think about, okay, somebody that's buying a home, what are some of the earliest things that they're going to be asking? Somebody that's selling a home, what are some of the earliest things that they're going to be asking? And how does that play into the messaging of that initial offer, that thing to get them to click off of Facebook and go to my website and perhaps give me their information, which speaks to campaign structure. So the role of the initial ad that that you put on Facebook is really to get people to engage, and often engagement means clicking away to your website. Okay, so the ad should give them just enough compelling detail about what they're going to in order to get them to click a link in the ad to go to your website to get more information. And depending on how you are structuring this, maybe that that your initial offer is something where they're going to opt in, they're going to request something for free, they're going to give their name, their email address, maybe more information in exchange for information, right? And so your goal needs to be to set that up in the Facebook ad so that when somebody clicks through from that Facebook ad, they say, oh, well, this looks interesting. And they're going to a page with the intent to actually request the information, right? Or perhaps your offer is actually a consultation. And so in that case, you might actually do it a little bit differently. It could be a free home price consultation. You know, schedule your free home price consultation here, and they're going to give you their name, their information. They're gonna pre-schedule like a call with you, and perhaps they're going to give you their address. And so this would be for home sellers. They're going to give you their address so that you're able to prepare a price report prior to the call, and so you can have a discussion with them. Well, at that point, like, you're talking to somebody who's ready to list their home. And so think about your initial offer and how that dictates the campaign structure, which is going to involve going to your website and requesting more information or scheduling a call with you or whatever. Now, there's a lot of specifics that go into different types of offers that I don't have space or time to go into here. But I mean, you have to think about the campaign structure. You have to think about what's the user experience and why are they going to be interested in going through that process with you, and like, what value do they get out of that? So we've talked about targeting, making sure that we're speaking to the right audience, and you can target specific audiences in Facebook. We've talked about your offer, making sure that you have an easy offer for them to respond to as like a first step that leads them down the path to purchase. We've talked about campaign structure, where your goal is to get them to engage, to click off of Facebook and to either opt in or to schedule a call or whatever the appropriate next step is in that selling process. And then we get to messaging. So I've been toying with this concept called social response copywriting. And that's because the fundamental principles and strategies of direct response absolutely still apply to social media. The voice, which equates to the techniques and tactics of implementation, is changing. It changes a little bit based on the media that you're using. And so, for example, on Facebook, you'll actually get rewarded if your ad feels like other things that are in the news feed, and that people engage with it in ways that are similar to what's in their news feed already. So when you think about, like, what does Facebook like their users to do? They like their users to click like, they like their users to comment, they like their users to engage, to share posts. And the more that you have users reacting in that way to your Facebook ads, the more you're going to show up higher and earlier in your users' scrolling of the newsfeed. And in fact, I recently saw a stat where the average Facebook user scrolls the entire length of the Statue of Liberty every day on Facebook in their newsfeed. And so they're scrolling a lot, but as you can imagine, the ads that show up the highest in that scroll, earliest in that scroll, are going to be the ads that are engaged with most readily. By the time somebody's like, you know, they've scrolled from Statue of Liberty's head down past the book and all that, down to Statue of Liberty's knees and robe, like they're in like infinite scroll mode and they're completely zoned out in Facebook trance, right? And so those ads are not going to get the same engagement. Well, if your ads are engaging, Facebook will actually charge you less and put you higher. They'll put you like in the Statue of Liberty's crown, right? But the way that you do that is you make it like other things in the newsfeed. And so having your language be more casual, having it be, having the content be more shareable. Like, what are the best neighborhoods in Lincoln, Nebraska? Here's our report, or you know, not even here's our report. Like, here's our article on the best neighborhoods in Lincoln, Nebraska, and if people in Lincoln see that, they might share it, especially if they see their own neighborhood there. So like, that's shareable content for the real estate niche, right? If it's interesting and useful, like if there's checklists, if there's things like that, people tend to find it more interesting and useful, and they want to be the person that shares things that are more interesting and useful. And so if you look at what is being shared on Facebook, you will learn a lot more about what, and not just Facebook, but all sorts of social media, you'll learn a lot more about what's going to work in terms of ads there too. The only difference is that you apply the principles and strategy of direct response, and you make sure that you have things like an offer and you have a place for people to go without being over the top, like, you know, click now, get whatever, whatever, which leads us to compliance. One of the biggest issues in the last couple of years on Facebook is actually writing compliant copy. And a lot of traditional direct response niches, especially things that are like, you know, lose 10 pounds in the next 30 days. And, you know, that type of weight loss offer doesn't work. You know, make $50,000 a year in your underwear at home. That doesn't work because Facebook doesn't want that kind of stuff showing up on their platform. And so compliance has gotten a lot more strict in terms of what is allowed to run. And in real estate, like especially just buying and selling homes, it's probably not as big of a deal. But in some industries, it is going to be a big deal. And you have to pay attention. Like, Facebook does not want, for example, time-limited benefit claims. So sell your home in 15 days. That's probably not going to be compliant on Facebook. Maybe. I don't know how hard they police that niche. But we'll help you sell your home. You know, five things you need to know before selling your home in Lincoln, Nebraska, and things like that. Those are going to be much more friendly for Facebook compliance. And all of this, like, to say that one of the best things that you could do is follow kind of the old value first funnel model. Like, I'm going to give you a consumer guide, I'm going to give you a checklist, I'm going to give you some bit of valuable information that you're going to use as you go through the process of deciding what to do about this transaction. And I'm through the information that I give you, I'm probably going to establish some buying criteria that's going to lead you to being interested in doing business with me. But in the initial ads, it's all about just delivering as much value as possible. And through that value, getting people to take a step further down that path to purchase, which again speaks back to getting the right offer and getting the right campaign structure. So all of this is like fundamental direct response principles and strategy. The only difference really is when you get to that superficial level of like language and stuff like that, Facebook has some preferences, social media has some preferences that are going to be a little bit different. And you know, I want to emphasize, like, figuring out how to set up a Facebook campaign is really easy. Facebook gives that information away for free. There's all sorts of books and stuff on it. But actually setting up the right offer and the right campaign structure and, you know, targeting to some degree, Facebook makes targeting pretty easy. And the message, you can test a lot of messages and see what works. But getting that offer right and getting the campaign structure right is going to go a long way towards your success. And that's what actually, honestly, not a lot of people talk about. But if you want to do Facebook lead generation for your business, whether you're in real estate or wherever else, that's going to be some of the most important stuff. What do you think? Do you have some experience experience that either agrees or contradicts this. Do you have questions? Leave those in the comments below. Also, make sure you click that like button so the magical algorithms of the internet know to share this with other people like you, and so you get more content like this delivered to you. Also, if you have somebody that you'd like to share this with, you can share it with them directly. And subscribe. If you're not yet a subscriber here, make sure to click that subscribe button. Also, go to breakthroughmarketingsecrets.com to get my Monday through Friday emails covering marketing, copywriting, business building, selling, direct response, and more. All of that's at breakthroughmarketingsecrets.com. And I've included a couple links in the description you'll want to check out as well, too. My name is Roy Furr. This is a video issue, Breakthrough Marketing Secrets. I hope you've gotten a lot of value, and I look forward to seeing you again in your next video. I'll see you soon. Bye.